Today we're going to talk about power. When I talk about power, I mean I'm talking about muscle power. There are three really interesting terms that we're seeing in the research literature, and the newest one just was published in, I think, May of 2024. And all this relates to, do we or are we working hard enough to maintain muscular power as we get older? Now, obviously, power is something that we're going to see expressed athletically across the world. It's something I think everyone's kind of visually drawn to. That's why athletes get paid so much money, because we love to see people move fast. We love to see them move powerfully. But this goes much more deeply into the actual function of our lives and just how well we perform athletically. So let's talk about three terms really quickly. As people get older, the first thing that we will begin to see them lose is muscle strength. All right, at least in previous research. And that is called dynapedia. All right, dynapedia. So we're losing dynamic capacity. Then we see a term called sarcopenia, which means a loss of muscle mass. And so in the aging population, one of our big concerns is, hey, as people are getting older, they're losing strength, they're losing mass. However, some newer research is also pointing to the fact that neither one of those actually explains everything, because what we are starting to notice is that it's not so much the loss of maximal strength, which is about dynapedia, but is instead the loss of power, our ability to explosively use muscles, to control our bodies, to prevent falls, etc. So some researchers, in trying to draw attention to this, have now recommended that we adopt the term powerpenia. All right, powerpenia, which I think is a really cool and self-correcting term. It makes it very evident. What are we trying to do? We're trying to make sure that you do not lose power as you age. Now, why is this important? Well, number one, when you look at the research, loss of power is the most predictive thing that we see in the aging population for risk of falls. It's not about how strong your grip is. It's not about how much more you can deadlift. It's about how quickly you can express that, which is about power. If I'm walking and I trip, it doesn't really matter how much I can deadlift. It matters how quickly can I use those muscles to correct my loss of balance. So we know that it is attached to better function across the board. Power is more important than the max strength. We also have seen some research showing that people who maintain power have better bone strength and in fact have better cognitive function. So across the board, what we're trying to now encourage people is don't stop training for explosiveness and power as you get older. The problem is it seems scarier. And a lot of people in the traditional movement world, we've kind of been taught, hey, as people get older, we need to be more and more cautious. We need to use more and more machine work with them. We want to really control tempos. That's great in some ways for preventing injury. At the same time, whenever we are fearful of asking people to do something that's a little bit more challenging for them, we're setting them up for injury. And in fact, if you've done my fall prevention course, if you are training people in such a way that you're not helping them prepare for falls, you may actually be hastening some really bad outcomes for them. So it is essential that we think this through and go, okay, well, what do we do about it? Well, the easiest thing that you can start to work on in terms of maintaining power, building power, is just look at how you're doing strength training right now. If I was going to do something as simple as a single arm chest press, right? Most of the time people are given a tempo. So we're going to say, okay, I want you to press out for 2 seconds, hold for whatever, or don't hold at all, and then do an eccentric for 2 or 3 seconds, right? That's kind of standard lifting tempos and the stuff, you know, if you've been in this world, you probably have a million different variations, and that's fine. If you are working with people and you are concerned about maintaining power, the easiest thing to do is to begin using explosive concentrics and a slower eccentric phase. What that would look like is, all right, you're going to push out. That's going to be the concentric. You're going to do it fast. And then you're just going to do a slow eccentric and a fast concentric and a slow eccentric. No big deal. Still safe. I'm still utilizing pretty much the same equipment. The only thing we're asking them to do now is to train their brain to use muscles explosively. I like to tell people strength is a skill, so it's something that can be learned, and speed is a skill, which it can also be learned. And when we talk about skills, that means they can be unlearned. So if you don't train, you can get weaker. If you don't train, you can get slower. If you do train, you can get stronger. And if you do train, you can get faster. And these are things that I want you to really consider as you're starting to build your own training programs. And I ask people at this age, all right, my stage of life, and after doing this for almost 30 years now, I like for people to think long-term, right? If you're working on a training program, you go, okay, how's this going to work for my client for the next 6 weeks or 8 weeks or 3 months? That's awesome. I want you to also consider, if they only do that for the next 10 years, what's missing. Because if you figure out what's missing now, you can save them and yourself a lot of problems in the long term. I'm not saying every exercise has to be performed that way, but if you remind the brain, I need to maintain explosiveness, it will work to do that, all right? And it is something that will, again, impact their functional outcomes as well as their cognitive function and their just ability to work through daily life safely, all right? So new term, powerpenia, don't forget about it. I think it's super instructive. If you are new to Z-Health, we're a brain-based education company. We work with doctors, coaches, and therapists around the world. So if you are interested in taking cutting-edge neuroscience, melding it with kinesiology, biomechanics, and other kind of traditional training paradigms, we are the company to work with. We have a bunch of free stuff for you. You can check out on our website. We also have a ton of blogs here, so subscribe to the channel, and we will see you again soon.